Today, I'll explain to you the incredibly small, yet very capable series of Arduino-compatible boards, the Seed Studio Shell. With 12 boards, as of now, it's a lot to cover, but will be done in under 500 seconds. Stick around until the end of the video for some advice on which board to choose for your project.
Xiao, from the Chinese word of small, with the meaning of tiny size, but in a very agile way. They are a collection of some size dev boards. Each shell board integrated different and popular and powerful SoCs like ESP32 and then RP2040. I think the first features that they have common is about the size, because like they are all sized at 21 plus 80.5 millimeters, if I didn't get it wrong. You can think about the size of two gummy bears. Apart from the tiny size, they all come with a single-sided surface mount design, which makes them really ready to blend in space-constrained projects and then to tap on any PCB designs. And then the second one I really want to mention is kind of like they also support mutable programming languages, including the C, and then Python, Go, and Rust. So I think that's also one of the reasons why they are really popular and trusted by over 500,000 developers all around the world.
Xiao SAMD21 is the original Xiao board launched in early 2020. It's a thumb-sized microcontroller board with 14 castellated pins, one LED, and a Type-C port. The processor used in the original board was Cortex-M0+, with clock rate of 48 MHz, 256 KB of flash, and 32 kilobytes of SRAM. It can be programmed with C++ using Arduino IDE, MicroPython, or Adafruit's fork of MicroPython called CircuitPython. 4 years later, it may be hard to understand, but at that time, having a microcontroller board that small, but more powerful than, for example, original Arduino Uno was a pretty big deal. You could even run simple machine learning models on it. But if you need more program space, or wireless, then you are out of luck with the original Xiao. Coming up next is Xiao RP2040, based on, surprise, surprise, Raspberry Pi RP2040 chip. So it's the same Cortex-M0+ core, but now we have two of them. 264 kilobytes of RAM and 2 MB of flash. That is much more space for your programs. The form factor of Xiao RP2040 and pretty much all of the boards that followed have stayed the same. So it's a thumb-sized dimensions and 14 pins. There were two more buttons added, however, the boot button and the reset button, and also one additional LED. One thing that was really missing though, and I felt it when working on my tiny machine learning project for Xiao, was wireless. The board was an amazing prototyping platform for wearables and tiny gadgets. But with no wireless, it would always have to be tethered with the cable if you needed to pass information from the board or into the board. Xiao and RF52840 changed that. The name of the chip might not tell you much, but it's the same chip as used inside of Arduino Nano 33 BLE Sense. Seed Studio managed to squeeze a lot more inside of the same tiny piece of PCB. The Sense version of the board has a PDM microphone and a 6-axis IMU sensor, so it's gyroscope and accelerometer. And despite the number of physical pins stayed the same, the number of pins you can use in your code has increased to as many as 20 in the upgraded version of the board called Xiao and RF52840+. The Plus version also has NFC pins exposed for the project that require near-field communication. Both regular and Plus versions also have battery charging chip and dedicated battery pins. And the RF-based Xiao was great, but it was getting a tad bit expensive. If there was a chip that combined wireless with affordable price, of course I'm talking about ESP32 chips. The first of the ESP32 Xiao series was Xiao ESP32C3, launched in July 2022. The board offered a single-core 32-bit RISC-V processor running up to 160 MHz, 400 kilobytes of RAM, and 4 megabytes of flash, integrated 2.4 GHz Wi-Fi, and Bluetooth Low Energy or BLE connectivity, and also power management capabilities. Or for $499, which is a tough price to beat. Later, the Seed Studio added Xiao ESP32S3 and Xiao ESP32C6. The S3 offers more performance, vector extensions for machine learning, even more flash, 8 megabytes of that, and improved power consumption in deep sleep mode. There is also a Sense version with OV2640 camera, a microphone, and SD card slot, which are mounted on extension boards. This is likely the smallest available camera board on the market with ESP32S3 chip. The C6 board, on the other hand, includes Wi-Fi 6, Bluetooth 5.3 low energy, and Zigbee and Threads protocol support, which makes it a top choice for future-proof home automation projects. Now, in the last few months, there were a few more new boards in the Xiao series. Xiao RP2350, Xiao RA4M1, and Xiao MG24. Xiao RP2350 is the most straightforward and easier to understand of all of them. Based on Raspberry Pi newest chip design, it offers what you have in Pi Pico 2, but in Xiao form factor, plus an RGB LED and a battery management system. It is also the first Xiao offering 8 more GPIO connectors placed on the back of the board. Xiao RA4M1 is powered by Renesas RA4M1 chip, a 32-bit ARM Cortex-M4 MCU operating at up to 48 MHz with a floating point unit, 256 KB of flash, and 32 kilobytes of SRAM. Xiao MG24 is based on Silicon Labs SoC and supports Matter protocol over Thread and Bluetooth Low Energy 5.3. The Sense version of MG24 board has an integrated microphone and 6-axis IMU sensor. The important thing to know about MG24 is its ultra-low power consumption of less than 5 microamperes per hour in a sleep mode. Over the years, Xiao series of the boards not only extended to as many as 12 boards we have now, but also included a number of expansion boards and sensors.
We also got a expanding range of tap-on accessories, all compatible with all the Xiao dev boards. We got expansion boards, making it very easy for all the Xiao dev boards to connect to over 300 different growth modules. And then we also have advanced sensors, such as like 2-mic arrays. And then for those who wanted to bring more connectivities to Xiao, we also got you covered too, LoRa, Mesh Testing, CAN Box, and then also even RS4A5. And last but not least, there are also LEDs, displays, and then even relays.
Which Xiao do you choose for your project? There is not much point in choosing the original Xiao SAMD21 unless you get it for free or very cheaply. If you absolutely know that you don't need any wireless, then go for Xiao RP2040 or RP2350. The first one being cheaper and currently available to $299. This is the cheapest Xiao board at the moment. If you do need Wi-Fi or Bluetooth and have a rather simple IoT application in mind, choose Xiao RP32C3. If you care more about performance and want to run some AI models on the device, then go for Xiao ESP32S3 instead. If you plan to use Thread and Matter, choose either Xiao MG24 or Xiao ESP32C6, the last one being an all-rounder with Wi-Fi available as well, but not carrying any sensors. Finally, if you want what is essentially a smaller version of Arduino and NS33 BLE Sense, then choose Xiao NRF52840. As you've noticed, a lot of the Xiao boards are based on ESP32 chips. If you feel like you're getting lost in all the types of ESP32 mentioned, then I got you covered in another video. Or take a look at how I used one of those ESP32 chips to build a robot with a tiny language model, baby ChatGPT, running inside of it.